GLP-1 receptor agonists have proven to be extremely beneficial for obesity, diabetes, and other cardiometabolic diseases. They have shown a reduction, a 20% reduction in major adverse coronary events. What are we talking about there? We're talking about things like strokes and heart attacks. We've also seen improvement in conditions like obstructive sleep apnea. For the first time, we actually have a medication that actually treats obstructive sleep apnea. In addition to this, what about the quality of life improvements? Significant. Patients are able to run after their grandkids or kids in ways that they weren't able to do prior to the utilization of these medications. This is all secondary to the use of these medications, first discovered using basic science, translating over to clinical care. So as we think about GLP-1 receptor agonists, we have to recognize that this was a thought that started decades ago. It really took us doing investigations, those by Dr. Habner and others, to really extrapolate that over to what we see in clinical care. When federal funding is cut, it really puts us at a deficit of our knowledge and understanding for particularly chronic disease. From a basic level, from a clinical level, questions are left unanswered. And so what happens? Discoveries go undiscovered. We aren't able to treat our patients effectively because the answer may have been there, but we never got to that answer. So it's important to have continuity of funding to ensure that we get the best possible outcomes to deliver the best possible patient care.